Let's make a travel translation app. For example, say you're traveling to Spain and you want to have a list of commonly used phrases handy for your travel with translation in text and audio. And you also want to be able to add to this list a few phrases that you think you would need. For example, say suppose you want to ask, where can I find coffee? Is this vegetarian? Things like that. So let's dive in and look at how we can build this. For front end of the app, we will be using FlutterFlow, and for back end to manage the data on Firestore, create translation to text and audio, we will be using Rowy. First, on the FlutterFlow side, you can build different screens that you need for the app, starting from the login screen where you can allow your users to sign in, sign up, or log in as a guest. Then we will have a home page with a list of languages as options that the user can select from. Once they have selected a language, they'll be able to see a list of commonly used phrases that they can use. There's a button at the bottom that allows users to add some phrases to their list as well. When someone clicks the button, they get to the screen where they can enter a text, and it automatically gives them the translation in text as well as audio. Additionally, you can have screens that show users' profiles, settings, and things like that. So once you have designed these screens on FlutterFlow using the intuitive drag and drop UI, let's see how you can connect to Firestore to make the app come alive with data. All that you need to do is go to the settings, add the Firestore collection that you want to connect to. Here, we have already made the connection to Firebase for your project, which is called Travel Phrases. To see a step-by-step guide on how you can connect to your Firebase project, I have linked to a tutorial in the description. Then to manage the data, we'll set up a few fields in your Firestore collection called Languages. First, a field called Language, then an image field for storing the flag of the country and the language code. Then in another collection called Translations, we will have a field called Language Code and the text that you want to translate, along with another field for storing the translated text as well as the audio file. Now you can go back to your screens view and connect these fields to relevant components. So under the home page, the list view is connected to the language collection, and each item container shows the flag as well as the language from that collection. And in the Translate Now page, when someone adds the text and clicks the Translate button, we'll add a tap action to add this data text as a document to the collection. This data then triggers a cloud function to generate both the translation text as well as the audio file. To learn how to create the cloud function in low code, manage the data, and build the backend functionality for the app using Rowy, check out the part 2 of this video.